This is K. Damodar Reddy. Today we are going to discuss photochemistry for a continuation previous class. Einstein's Stark law, Stark-Einstein law. According to this, each molecule of absorbing substance absorbs one photon or quantum of the radiation in primary process. So quantum yield or quantum efficiency. Quantum yield or quantum efficiency is ratio between number of molecules reacting in a given time, number of quanta of light absorbed in the same time, or number of molecule reacting in a given time, molecules reacting in a given time, number of Einstein of light observed in the same time. So this is called as a quantum yield or quantum efficiency denoted by pi. So the quantum yield or quantum efficiency is ratio between number of molecules reacting in a given time, number of quanta of light absorbed in the same time, or number of molecules reacting in a given time, number of Einstein of light absorbed in the same time. So quantum efficiency or quantum yield may be unity, greater than 1, less than 1. So reasons for unity quantum yield. According to Einstein's law of photochemical equivalence, in primary process, each molecule absorbs one quanta. Hence, quantum yield is unity. So pi is equal to 1. Many reactions, quantum yield or quantum efficiency value is greater than 1 or less than 1. So the deviation from Einstein's law of photochemical equivalence due to primary process. It is the first process in which one molecule reacts for one quantum of absorbed radiation. So the quantum yield to be unity. The excited molecules or atoms or free radicals produced in the primary process. Secondary process can take place in the dark also. Due to this process, different number of molecules may undergo reaction by absorbing one quantum only. As a result, the quantum yield of the reaction will differ from unity. It may be lower or higher. Lower means it is the less than 1. Higher means it is greater than the 1. So what is the reasons for high quantum yield? High quantum yield may be due to the chain reaction. High quantum yield may be due to the formation of intermediate product acting as a catalyst. The reactions may be exothermic, and heat evolved may activate other molecules due to which a high quantum yield is observed. The reactions between hydrogen and Cl2 involve very high quantum yield of the 10 to the power of 4 to 10 to the power of 6. So take the example, H2Cl2 reaction. primary process of the reaction is the dissociation of one molecule of chlorine for quantum of radiation. So Cl2 plus H nu giving rise to Cl radical plus Cl radical. This is the first equation. The quantum yield is unity according to the law of photochemical equivalence. But overall quantum yield is found to be very high. And it varies from 10 to the power of 4 to 10 to the power of 6. This is because the reason. So Cl radical reacts with hydrogen molecule, gives HCl plus hydrogen radical. This hydrogen radical reacts with the Cl2 molecule, gives HCl, Cl radical. The reactions 2 and 3 are repeated for large number of times and chain is propagated. So here, large number of molecules react by absorbing only one quantum of radiation energy, and hence quantum efficiency is found to be high. The reaction which proceeds by a series of successive process is called a chain reaction. Atoms which propagate the chain are called chain carriers. Here, in this reaction, hydrogen radical and Cl radicals are the chain carriers. Chain reactions are break by chain terminating steps. So hydrogen radical giving rise to hydrogen H2, Cl radical plus Cl radical giving rise to Cl2, hydrogen radical plus Cl radical is giving rise to HCl. So hydrogen radical plus O2 giving rise to HO2 radical. So like this, this is the terminating step. Reasons for high quantum yield. So high quantum means pi is greater than 1, not for unity. So the product of primary process may collide with the second molecule and transfer energy, second to third, and so on. Thus chain reaction starts and number of reacting molecules will be high. Due to formation of intermediate product which act as a catalyst. So exothermic reaction may activate more molecules. The example for high quantum yield is reaction between hydrogen and Cl2. So reasons for low quantum yield. If the product are excited particles formed in the primary process are such that they cannot react due to the deactivation by collisions, by re-emitted, by internal arrangements, or by coming in contact with the inert molecules, or by thermal reactions, the quantum yield will be extremely low. So once again repeat my word. So what are the reasons for low quantum yield? So if the product or excited particle formed in the primary process are such that they cannot react due to their deactivation by collisions, or re-emitted, or by internal arrangements, or by coming in contact with the inert molecules, or by thermal reactions. Therefore, the quantum yield will be extremely low. The products of primary process may recombine so as to form reactants, so as to give low quantum yield. For example, decomposition of HA, decomposition of HBr, and polymerization of anthracene, etc., involve low quantum yields. So take the example of decomposition of HI or HBr. The electronic spectrum of HI is found in the continuous region, and hence the primary process is the dissociation of absorbing molecule. The quantum yield in the photochemical decomposition of HI using wavelengths in ultraviolet region has been found to be close to 2. The primary photochemical process can be represented as HI plus H nu giving rise to hydrogen radical plus iodine radical. So HI molecule absorbs a photon or quantum, giving us dissociation of HI molecule gives us hydrogen radical plus iodine radical. Here, one molecule of HI absorbs one quantum of radiation as required by the Einstein's torque law. The hydrogen and iodine atom then undergoes secondary process as hydrogen radical plus HI giving rise to H2 plus iodine radical. So the overall photochemical process is obtained by adding all above reactions as 2HI plus H nu giving rise to H2 plus I2. Thus, two molecules of HI are decomposed by each quantum of radiation absorbed. The absorbed value of 2 per quantum yield can thus be explained by above mechanism. So as the reaction proceeds, the quantum yield falls below 2 because of the thermal reaction. So H plus I2 giving rise to HI plus I radical. Hydrogen radical plus I2 giving rise to HI plus iodine radical. The photochemical decomposition of HBr proceeds in a similar way, and the corresponding the reactions are similar to reactions A, comma B and C, but the quantum yield falls off more rapidly as the protonation of molecular bromine increases. That is the thermal reaction, hydrogen radical plus Br2 giving rise to HBr plus Br radical, takes place more rapidly or readily. So for low quantum yield means quantum efficiency less than 1 or a quantum yield less than 1. In some reaction, deactivation of activated molecule take place in primary process before transfer to product. The product of primary process may react back to form reactants. That is the main reason for low quantum yield of the HI and HBr reactions of decomposition. So what are the facts affecting on quantum yield? You can see here, all primary photochemical process is endothermic. Hence, quantum yield increases with the temperature. So quantum yield directly proportional to the temperature. We know energy absorbed by molecule is inversely proportional to wavelength. Hence, quantum yield will be higher at the lower wavelength, and vice versa. So that means quantum yield inversely proportional to the wavelength. as speed of photochemical reaction is proportional to intensity of light. Hence, quantum yield increases with the intensity and vice versa. So see here, quantum yield increases with the temperature. That means quantum yield directly proportional to the temperature. Whereas second effect, wavelength. So quantum yield indirectly proportional to the wavelength, inversely proportional to the wavelength. Whereas quantum yield increases with the intensity of light, therefore quantum yield directly proportional to the intensity of the light. These are the factors affecting the quantum yield. So experimental determination of quantum yield: determination of number of moles reacted, determination of number of Einsteins absorbed. In this experiment, so source of light, monochromator, reaction cell, detector. This is the single beam spectrophotometer. It is helpful to determine the quantum yield. So this is the light source, this is the lens, monochromator, and the sample. This is the reaction cell. You can take the sample in reaction cell. You can find the detector, analysis of the compound from detector. This is the helpful for determine the quantum yield. So next we are discuss photosensitized reactions. Photosensitized reactions: in some reactions, the reacting molecule is unable to absorb the radiation itself. However, if a suitable atom or molecule called as sensitizer is present to absorb the radiation, and the reaction takes place, such a reaction is called a photosensitized reaction. Which molecule absorbs the photons or radiation, that is called as the sensitizer. So dissociation of hydrogen, for example, dissociation of hydrogen, ultraviolet light of 25-37 angstrom does not dissociate hydrogen molecule through its process. More energy than required for dissociation, because the molecule is unable to absorb this radiation. However, if a small amount of mercury vapor is present as a sensitizer, dissociation of hydrogen takes place, the reaction can be Hg plus Hν giving rise to Hg star. This is the excited mercury atom. So this excited mercury atom reacts with hydrogen H2 molecule. So here hydrogen molecule excited. This is using for dissociation of hydrogen using of mercury atom. Here mercury is a photosensitizer. The reaction is called as the photosensitized reaction. So mercury helps to dissociate the hydrogen molecule. Another important one is photosynthesis. In photosynthesis, the photosynthesis reaction also, chlorophyll is a photosensitizer. The reaction is called photosensitization reaction. chlorophyll act as a sensitizer in the process of photosynthesis. That is interaction of CO2 and H2O in sunlight to form carbohydrates and oxygen. This is a photosensitization. Occurs in green plants, the influence of visible light of wavelength from 4000 to 7000 angstroms. Neither water nor carbon dioxide absorbs radiations in this region, but chlorophyll absorbs radiation almost over the whole range. The overall reaction is as CO2 plus H2O, sunlight and chlorophyll, you can get the carbohydrates and oxygen. So this is a photosynthesis reaction. In photosynthesis reaction, chlorophyll is the photosensitizer. The whole reaction is called as the photosensitization reaction. See, once again, repeat it today class. So here we can know the Einstein's Stark law before we're going to discussion of quantum efficiency or quantum yield. According to Stark-Einstein law, each molecule absorbs one photon of the radiation in primary process. So quantum yield or quantum efficiency, denoted by pi, we can define the quantum yield, the ratio between number of molecules reacting in a given time, number of quanta of light absorbed in the same time. Another definition, number of molecule reacting in a given time or number of Einstein of light observed in the same time. So the ratio between number of molecules reacting in a given time, number of Einstein of light absorbed in the same time. Or another definition is number of molecules undergoing the process, the ratio between number of molecules undergoing the process and the number of quanta absorbed. It is a quantum efficiency or quantum yield. So quantum yield is unit. So this is the pi value is equal to 1 according to Einstein law. So according to Einstein law of photochemical equivalence in primary process, that is each molecule observe one quanta, that's why quantum yield is unity. Pi is equal to 1. For many reactions, the quantum yield or quantum efficiency greater than 1 or less than 1. If quantum yield or quantum efficiency pi is greater than 1, those reactions are called as a high quantum yield reactions. If quantum yield or quantum efficiency less than 1, those are the low quantum yield reactions. So the deviation from Einstein law of photochemical equivalence, primary process, it is the first process in which one molecule reacts for one quantum of absorbed radiation. So the quantum yield to be unity. The excited molecules or atoms or radicals produced in the primary process. Secondary process can take place in the dark also. So that means, so absorption of light is not useful in secondary process. That's why called as a dark reaction. Due to this process, different number of molecules may undergo reaction by absorbing one quantum only. as a result, quantum yield of reaction will differ from unity. It may be lower or higher. So the quantum yield may be unity or may be lower or may be higher. It is depending on secondary process. So reasons of high quantum yield. High quantum yield may be due to the chain reaction. High quantum yield may be due to the formation of intermediate product acting as a catalyst. The reactions may be exothermic and heat evolved may active other molecules due to which a high quantum yield is observed. The reaction between hydrogen and Cl2, the quantum yield of the reaction is 10 to the power of 4 to 10 to the power of 6. This is the example for high quantum yield or high quantum efficiency. See here, in primary process, dissociation of one molecule of chlorine for quantum of radiation, Cl2 plus H nu, giving rise to Cl radical, Cl radical. This is the one reaction. The quantum yield is unity according to the law of photochemical equivalence, according to Einstein's Stark law. But overall, quantum yield is found to be very high and it varies from 10 to the power of 4 to 10 to the power of 6. This is due to the secondary process of this reaction. What is the secondary process? So Cl radical reacts with H2, giving rise to HCl plus hydrogen radical. This hydrogen radical reacts with the Cl2 molecule, giving rise to HCl plus Cl radical. But in this secondary process, hydrogen radical and the Cl radicals are obtained. The reaction second and third are repeated for a large number of times and the chain is propagated. This is the chain propagation step. So here large number of molecules react by absorbing only one quantum of radiation energy and hence the quantum efficiency found to be high. The reaction which proceeds by a series of successive process is called a chain reaction. Atoms which propagate the chain are called chain carriers. In this reaction, hydrogen radical and Cl radicals are chain carriers. Chain reactions are break by chain terminating steps as this is the terminating step. Hydrogen radical giving rise to H2 molecule, Cl radical giving rise to Cl2, hydrogen radical, Cl radical giving rise to HCl, like this. So, pi is greater than 1. What is the reason for high quantum yield? The product of primary process may collide with the second molecule and transfer energy third and so on. Thus, chain reaction starts and number of reacting molecules will be high due to the formation of intermediate product which act as a catalyst. Exothermic reaction may active more molecules. So that's why the quantum yield is pi is greater than 1. Reasons of low quantum yield. If the product or excited particle formed in the primary process are such that they cannot react due to their reactivation by collisions or by re-emitted or by internal rearrangements or by coming in contact with the inert molecules or by thermal reactions, the quantum yield will be extremely low. The product of primary process may recombine so as to form reactants so as to give low quantum yield. The example for low quantum yield decomposition of HI and HBr polymerization of anthracene. So see here example for decomposition of HI and HBr for low quantum yield. The electronic spectrum of HI is found in the continuous region and hence the primary process is the dissociation of absorbing molecule. The quantum yield in the photochemical decomposition of HI using wavelengths in ultraviolet region has been found to be close to 2. The primary photochemical process can be represented as HI plus H nu giving rise to hydrogen radical and iodine radical. Here one molecule of HI absorbs one quantum of radiation as required by the Einstein's formula. The hydrogen and iodine radical then undergo secondary process like this. So the overall photochemical process is obtained by adding 2 HI plus H nu giving rise to H2 plus I2. Thus two molecules of HI are decomposed by each quantum of radiation observed. The observed value of 2 for quantum yield can thus be explained by above mechanism of the reaction. As the reaction proceeds, the quantum yield falls below 2 because of the thermal reaction. So in some reactions, what is the reasons for low quantum yield? Pi is less than 1. In some reaction, deactivation of activated molecule take place in primary process before transfer to product. The product of primary process may react back to form reactants. Factors affecting quantum yield. So here quantum yield directly proportional to the temperature. That means all primary photochemical process is endothermic, hence quantum yield increases with the temperature. So wavelength inversely proportional to the quantum yield. So we know energy absorbed by molecule is inversely proportional to wavelength. Hence quantum yield will be higher at the lower wavelength and vice versa. So next, intensity of light. As speed of photochemical reaction is proportional to intensity of light. Hence quantum yield increases with the intensity of light. That means quantum yield directly proportional to the intensity of light. Experimental determination of quantum yield. So in this experiment, source of light, monochromator, reaction cell, detector are useful for determination of quantum yield by experimentally. This is the single beam spectrophotometer. In this spectrophotometer, light source, lens, monochromator, reaction cell, detectors are mainly used. So here you can take the sample. You can calculate the quantum yield of the sample. So photosensitized reactions. In some reactions, the reacting molecules is unable to absorb the radiation itself. However, if a suitable atom or molecule called as a sensitizer is present to absorb the radiation, and the reaction takes place. Such a reaction is called as a photosensitized reaction. So, for example, dissociation of hydrogen. Ultraviolet light of 2537 angstrom units does not dissociate a hydrogen molecule through heat process. more energy than required for dissociation because the molecule is unable to absorb this radiation. However, if a small amount of mercury vapor is present as a sensitizer, dissociation of hydrogen takes place. So here mercury plus H nu, so excited mercury atom is formed. This is the photosensitizer. This excited mercury dissociates the hydrogen molecule. So this excited mercury dissociates the hydrogen molecule. The reaction is called as the photosensitizer reaction. The here sensitizer is mercury. You can take the photosynthesis. So photosynthesis reaction also is a photosensitized reaction. Here chlorophyll absorbs the energy or photons. So to react the carbon dioxide water molecules in between carbon dioxide, react the in between carbon dioxide water molecule. So without chlorophyll, no reaction takes place. That's why this is the photosensitized reaction. So thank you. Thank you all and all.